Okay, Baruch Hashem. We're getting close to Purim. Today is Hey Adar Sheni. Hey in Adar Sheni. Right? Purim is in Baruch Hashem less than 10 days. Baruch Hashem. Oh, if Yerushalayim is 10 days. So today we're learning Hilchot Din Me'ot Purim La'aniyim. We know in Purim we have four mitzvot that we do. Right? The first mitzvah is we read Megillah. The second mitzvah is we give ma'ot la'aniyim, we give money to the poor. There's laws for each thing. The third mitzvah is mishloach manot, we give food to friends. And the fourth mitzvah is we make a big seudah. Four mitzvot on Purim, and each mitzvah has laws. So we learned until now a lot of laws regarding the mitzvah of Megillah. That's the past few shiurim. Today we're starting Siman Taf Reish Tzadik Dalet, 694, and we're going to start learning the halachot of giving tzedakah to the aniyim on Purim, giving to the poor money on Purim. It says here in Shulchan Aruch, Chayav kol adam niten lefachot shtei matanot lishnei aniyim. Each, it says in the Gemara in Megillah, each person is obligated to give at least minimum of two gifts of money to two poor people, meaning a gift to each poor person. What's considered a gift? We'll see in a second. Yesh omrim, some say, שיש ליתן קודם פורים מחצית מן המטבע הקבוע באותו מקום ובאותו זמן, זכר למחצית השקל שהיו נותנים באדר. Some say, regard, now nothing to do with what we just said, you have to give מתנות לאביונים, and Purim, each one has to give minimum of a certain small amount of money, any type, one shekel is good enough, $1 is good enough, a minimum to one person, another minimum to another person, and by this he fulfills the mitzvah of giving the poor matanot, gifts. Okay?
There is maximum?
He feels it. No maximum. You can give as much as you want. But tell you what's the minimum? Okay? Yofi. Now, the Rama says, there's a different thing that's called a zecher l'machatzit ha-shekel. We spoke about this before. At the time of the Beit HaMikdash was still here, soon, there was a mitzvah called Machatzit HaShekel that in the Chodesh Adar, the Jews, every Jew used to bring a half of a silver shekel, which was a certain amount of silver, right? And that's what they used to bring to Beit HaMikdash. Each Jew had to bring, and with that they bought sacrifices, and with that they fixed the Beit HaMikdash. They did things with that. But in our days, we don't have Beit HaMikdash. Nevertheless, there's still a minhag, which is called Zecher L'machatzit HaShekel, not to forget that there's such a mitzvah, because it doesn't exist yet anymore, not yet. So we have to give Zecher L'machatzit HaShekel. How much do you give? And when do you give it? So the mitzvah is usually people give it, you give it now if you want, but usually you give it on Purim, on Erev Purim. On Erev Purim, right? When we go to Davin Mincha, before the Megillah, people give Zecher L'machatzit HaShekel. How much do you give? And by the way, it says in the verse, three times the word Machatzit HaShekel. So therefore, the minhag is to give three times Machatzit HaShekel. How much is three times Machatzit HaShekel? The question is, do I have to bring a half of the amount of silver that it was in those days? Which is not such little money. It's about 45 shekels each half shekel. It's half a shekel of silver, is about 48 shekels, something like that. And you have to give three times for you, for your wife, for your kids. It's a lot of money. You come out broke. How are you going to make the promise with that? Right? But according to the Shulchan Aruch, according to the Sfaradim, nevertheless, you have to give three times half a shekel. According to the Rama, no. Each state, where do you live? You live in the Ukraine, you have to give half a grivna. Perfect. It's half a grivna. It's nothing. You live in a European country, you give half a euro. You live in the United States, you give half a dollar. You live in Canada, you give half a Canadian dollar. You live in Israel, you give half a shekel, three times. That's easy already. You could also, but because it's so little, what's three half shekels? It's nothing. What could you do more? You could also, in many shuls, they have they have three half shekels in the box. And you give whatever you want for tzedakah, and you pick up the half shekel, three half shekels, and you throw them back in. So you gave also 3 half shekels, and also you gave donation to whatever cause that there is there on the table. As all you'll see if you go to Bet Knesset and Mincha, if you remember from last year's, so there's all kinds of plates and all kinds of pushkas, and you give tzedakah. But that's Zecher Malchus HaShekel. Moseda. Yafeh mod. Some say only if you're over 20 years old, but some say also for your kids you should give. It's just a minhag again. Just a custom. Now, on Purim, the tzedakah of Purim, everyone is obligated to give. A man is obligated to give, and a woman is obligated to give. Not only the man, but the man can give for his wife too. Okay? He can give for his wife too. He can give to poor people, and then he can give them again and say, this is for my wife. Here, I'll give you more. As Yotze, the mitzvah of matanot la'evyonim, that's how you do. Now, sometimes you want to give on Purim, okay? And maybe you're not going to meet poor people. You want to give a certain person. You don't want to give, and you're not going to see him. You want to give a certain friend of yours who you know he needs money, and you know you're not going to see him on Purim. So what could you do? You give it to him before Purim and tell him, please watch this for me until Purim. And on Purim, you could get it. So he has to put it aside. It's not his yet. Right? It's not his. It's still mine. I tell him, you're watching this 100 shekels now for me. Watch this. And on Purim, you can get, it's yours. So then I'm fulfilling the mitzvah of giving the tzedakah on Purim. Okay? As you could do that too. You could also give it to an organization that gives out on Purim. Like in my neighborhood, there's an organization that you could give them now already. They're already collecting a lot of money from people. And on Purim, they're going to go and they know who to give, and they give certain families, they give them envelopes full of money, a lot of money, 500 shekels, 600, 7,000 shekels, each one, but I don't know what they base there. I guess they know. Okay, but they give people a lot of money and they can start collecting now. So the people who gave already, they're fulfilling the mitzvah 100%. Why? Because they gave in with a thought that it will be given on Boy Bayoyim, they call it, on the day of Purim. Masada, that's this halacha. The second halacha is, okay. Oh, one second. Before we go on, I have to say this Mishnah Berurah is very important. By the way, even if a person is poor and he himself is collecting money, also he has to give tzedakah on Purim. It says in Mishnah Berurah, very important halacha, and we're going to read it in. Let's read it. It says, shtei matanot. You have to give two gifts to two poor people. Each one gets one. Minimum. Zehu midina. That's the minimum. That's the law. This, you have to do this. Ava be'emet, but in truth, mutav le'arbot matanot le'evyonim. It's better to give a lot of money to the poor mile'arbot b'sudato v'shloch mat le'rab than making a big purim suda with a very expensive meat and wine, right? Or making very expensive shalach manis people give, right? And they give the poor, they give one shekel, or 50 shekels, 100 shekels, but on their suda, they spend 2,000 shekels. And on the shalach manot, they spend another 1,000 shekels. And the poor, they give 100 shekels. So he says, no, wrong. How much are you going to give the, how much are you making of your purim suda? You make a purim suda of 1,000 shekels? So give at least 1,000 shekels to the poor. Spend more money on giving tzedakah to the poor than your shalach manis or your feast, your bottles of wine. You'll buy, instead of buying 3 bottles of 200 shekels a bottle, buy 3 bottles of 50 shekels a bottle, and the rest that you were going to spend on the wine, give to the poor. That's a better thing to do. That's what Mishnah Berurah says, right? Because it's so much better to lesamech levaniim, to make the heart of the poor happy, yetomim, and orphans, ve'almanot, and widows. Ve'domeh la'shchina, the person who does that, he is now, he is likely similar to the shchina, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Okay? There's verses for this. Yeah. Now, you can't give this money for ma'aser. Ma'aser money that you give is for voluntary things, but things that you're obligated to give, and one of the things is matanot levin, you're obligated to do that. You can't give it for your ma'aser money because you're obligated to give it. Your ma'aser money you can give for any other cause of tzedakah which you're not obligated to give. But you're the money for Purim, since you're obligated to give tzedakah on Purim, it's one of the 4 mitzvah that we do on Purim, you can't use your ma'aser money for that. Now, when do you do it? The minag is to give it immediately after the Megillah laning, after the Shacharis. You finish davening in the Purim morning, that's when you give the tzedakah in the morning. Sedar? That's when you give, and then afterwards you do Mishloach Manot immediately. You should always, everyone should take the shul with him, at least one Shalach Manes, that we're going to learn the Halachot soon, and bring money with him, and immediately after Shacharit, you give someone. Or if he gave already before, that's even good, also good. You give before and he told the person that it's not yours until Purim. Keep it in your pocket until Purim, and then Purim it's yours. And then he's yotze the mitzvah too. And yafeh mod. Okay? Okay, another halacha. It says, אין משנים מאות פורים לצדקה אחרת, ודווקא הגבאים, אבל אני יכול לעשות מה שירצה... If someone collected money for others for Purim, he can't say, oh, since I collected money, now I'll use it for a different tzedakah cause. No. You collected money for Purim cause, for the poor for Purim, you have to give this money davka on Purim. But a poor person who received money from someone, right, for Purim, right, he could do whatever he wants with the money. He could pay the electricity bill. He could go skiing if he wants. He could do whatever he wants with that money. But the person who's collecting for others... So he has to use it for the certain cause that he collected it for. He cannot use it for, in general, you collected it for Purim, you have for Purim. But if someone private received money for Purim, he doesn't have to use it for Purim, he can do whatever he wants with it. Okay?